Hey, welcome back to the Mr. Excel netcast. I'm Bill Jelen. Today we have a question sent in by Kim. Kim sent this in on the 10th anniversary webinar. She said, when I see a formula that has the minus minus, what are you trying to do there? And basically, I'm going to set up a simple situation. We have a data set here, region, product, and sales. I want to figure out the sales for East ABC. Now, in Excel 2007, we can use the new SUMIFS, but in the old versions of Excel, we were stuck with SumProduct. Basically, what this is doing, let's say that we take a look at everything from A2 to A11 and see if it's equal to that word East up there in E1. I'll press Control Shift Enter, and you see that I get a series of trues and falses. And if I do the same thing over here for the ABCs, so we check B2 to B11, see if it's equal to F1. Control Shift Enter, I get a series of trues and falses. Now, in the old Boolean logic, you could take true times a number, and it would come up with the number, and then true times false, or false times a number, was 0. But for some weird reason, Excel simply cannot deal with that. When we use SumProduct and multiply those three ranges together, we're getting nothing. So the reason that people use the minus minus is that that is a clever way to coerce Excel to change those trues and falses back to zeros and ones. So Control Shift Enter, we get a series of zeros and ones. The trues are 1, the falses are 0. I'll do that again here, minus minus, and now you see that the sum product starts to work. And so when people need to do conditional calculations, let's see what the West XYZ is. You'll see them using SumProduct with minus minus. Now, the other way to go is actually to not separate those ranges by commas, but to use a multiplication sign. And that also will force Excel to coerce those trues and falses into zeros and ones. So, either method seems to be on the Mr. Excel board. They tend to like to use the minus minus. Personally, I use the multiply, but either one will work. Kim, thanks for sending that question in. Thanks for attending the webinar. And thanks to you for stopping by. We'll see you next time for another netcast from Mr. Excel.